this is not a doing. An unfolding. Spontaneous. Unexpected. Natural. Notice the sense of being, the sense of presence, which indicate I'm simply here. And this sense, this knowingness, is at the root of all perception. You're simply here. You're not on a journey. There's no destination. You're simply here. You're not waiting. Not waiting. Just here. Notice this. So there's no expectations. There's no such thing as next. You're simply here. Notice that this sense of here-ness is not a geographical location. It's more the quality of presence. Therefore, wherever the body is placed, the inner sense is, I am here. So if the eyes were closed and the body was lifted and taken somewhere, another location, the sense is still, I am here. Not the words, I am here. The sense, I am here. Notice the sense of completeness, the natural stillness and silence, which appear as the very perfume of here-ness. Not focusing on the body, but on the sense of being inside the body. The beingness is not the size of the body. It is without size. Unlike the body, it has neither front, nor back, nor side. And again, you're not waiting. You're simply here. If the sense that the body feels heavy or the feeling that sleep is coming, this sense of presence is not asleep. It is not sleep. If the head feels like falling, stay only as this awareness. And the awareness is neither tired nor excited, indescribable. Even a sense of presence seems to pervade and permeate all the senses. So they also come into silence also. There's nothing to do. There's nothing to change or to fix. Nothing to get away from. There's nothing to become. If a thought should appear, it is just like a cloud passing. Do not follow or cling to any thought. Past, present, future. These are only thoughts for you. Whatever comes, whatever goes, it is not you. Do not hold on to any shape or image and call that yourself. Shapes and images come and go and are noticed in the space of yourself. There's nothing to be, nothing to become. Thank you. sense of being is vast, without boundary. Look. Without turning to the left or right. It is as though it is spread out infinitely. Yet it is not an object. Not holding to the body. You have no name. Being aware of concepts, you are beyond the concepts. Being aware of the sense of time, you're beyond time. Being aware of names and forms, you are beyond names and forms. Being aware of the zones of past and present and future. You're beyond them. What shape are you? What size? What weight? Even what gender, even? Like space, you're beyond quality. And you are not imagining this, not creating, simply noticing. Being formless, where is front and back for you? What is high or low for you? Notice the body. It has a weight and shape and form. But you, the weakness of this, are you a body? Don't imagine. don't create. You're simply here. It is not a journey. It has no name. Like an open space where all sensations can come and go, thoughts can come and go. Nothing has come and stayed. But the space does not complain. It is always empty. Even this very emptiness itself is noticed in you. Therefore, you are beyond emptiness and fullness. You are not the size of your body. You are sizeless, weightless, formless. You are here. There's no waiting, no expecting, no next. The sense of past or future are mere ideas for you. Every sensation, however subtle, is effortlessly perceived in you. Yet you are not doing nor undoing. Who are you? Mind wants to go into sleep, but this is noticed. You are not asleep. Beyond sleeping or even waking, you are. Can you touch yourself? far, far away is the voice of the psychological mind. Yourself is like space, moving in space, being still in space. You're neither hungry nor thirsty. You're beyond need, beyond sickness, beyond the varying states of mind. And yet you're just here. How is this possible? What is day or night for you? What is time? What in you can become disturbed? Even if there should be a sense or a wave of disturbance. Who is there to be disturbed? Though you're aware of the senses, you're beyond the senses. Though you observe the mind, you're beyond mind. Though you feel and perceive the body, you're beyond body. Your mind is in a state of pure neutrality. It is not shopping for experiencing. You are not the content of memory, nor the one who remembers. Before all beginnings, throughout all duration, after all endings, you remain the same. You're not the hand that holds, or the feet that walks, nor the mind that thinks. You neither gain nor lose anything. You're pure spirit, pure being. This you may confirm. Though it might be said that you have a body, you're also beyond the body. You're not the product of thought, nor emotion, nor any sensation. You are that which perceives the eyes opening, eyes closing. You see simultaneously inside and outside. Where precisely are you? Far, far away is the carnal mind. Again, notice you're not waiting. You're without expectation. There's nothing to wait for. You're in your completeness. Whatever is appearing in the mind are momentary, ephemeral, of no real significance. Let them come and go. you as you are now, where will you end? What is the end of your state? Are you a visitor here in the realm of being? In a few moments, you will hear the sound of the bell. Must you leave? Will you become another? Notice that in the field of the changeful, there is something unchanging. In the field of the formful, there is something that is formless. In the realm of time, there is the timeless. In the strongest storm, there is a stillness. Find that stillness in you. Notice again how effortless you are, without plans, without design, without strategies, without techniques, without intention, without fear. This is your natural state. While the body-mind moves about in the world, inwardly remain in pure serenity. This is easy for you. You are this, you are here, before remembering. Don't be merely a visitor here. Marinate in yourself. There is no conflict between activity and this inner serenity. This secret you are discovering. Don't say, this thing or that thing should not be. Simply remain as awareness self. And observe that life takes care of life. Being free of ego, there is no difference between the Buddha and your own self, between the Christ consciousness and your own self. Being free of psychological identity. You are freedom itself. In a few moments, you will hear the sound of the bell. It should make no difference to your inmost state. Outwardly, on the surface of consciousness and in the body, you may open your eyes, you may move around to bring comfort to your limbs. You may wish to sit here for a while. All this is fine. Though the body will move about, you will notice the unmoving. In the midst of sound or noise, you will notice your inherent silence. Even if your own mouth speaks, even the subtlest thing reports to your consciousness without any effort on your part. Such is the marvelousness of consciousness. How wonderful is consciousness! How pure, unstainable, imperishable. Notice eyes open, eyes closed, eyes open, eyes closed. No difference in the beingness. Eyes open, eyes closed. Turn to left, turn to right. Stand, sit, lie down. No difference to the beingness. Unless or until mind says something has happened, effectively, experientially, nothing has happened. You are not a happening. But happenings don't offend you, nor alter your true state. So it is not that you don't care, but more that you don't mind. Marinate in your own self. Don't listen to the opinions of the mind. Stay as the self. Though it seems a very passive advice, it is the most powerful. Because it will begin to release unexpected power and insight inside the being. And what others study for, you will seem somehow just come to know.